I remember that at least from the age of 13 or 14, my interest in mathematics became quite focused. And especially I was interested in algebra and number theoretic problems and areas. After that, I got admission into IIT Kanpur. So initial years, I was able to find courses, few courses which were in math, in dealing with algebra and related areas. So I was more interested in taking those courses than taking courses which were heavily applied or heavily practical. So ultimately I found out that complexity theory is an area where I can do work which will be in the intersection of mathematics as well as in computer science. So that is where I finally settled. And so once we started working with Professor Manin Agarwal, we focused on this problem of primality testing, which is again a problem which is to do with several areas. So it is of interest in algebra, in number theory, and in computer science. So this again was a natural fit with my interests. And since it was an open problem since forever, and there was a lot of interest in solving this problem, so we were quite charged up. And we came up with conjectures, and we were able to finally, after much work and many failures, we were able to solve it. So this happened in 2002. So after that, once I started my PhD, I got to know about a bigger, more general program in complexity theory, which is related to a question about algebraic circuits. So this question is called polynomial identity testing, and so this question is an innocuous question. So the question is that you are given a circuit and you have to test whether it vanishes absolutely. And so this is like in high school you have seen identities like x square minus y square factors as x minus y times x plus y. So if somebody gives you such an identity with, say, many variables and a big expression, how do you test whether that identity is true or false? So testing that is a fundamental computational algebra question. And the interesting thing is that it is of interest to computer scientists, because if you solve this problem, then it solves many other problems in computer science and in complexity theory. So this is the general program in which I work, and it leads to many other problems, and in some of these problems I have made some progress, some of the special cases I have been able to solve, but the general program still stands. So the general open problems are still open, and this is what I plan to work on in the next years. In general, algebra and number theory they have found a significant amount of practical applications since the 1970s. So this happened because security, cryptography, cyber security, etc. were needed. Once the computers became big in society and in the industry. And so currently the only known practical security solutions known are based on algebra and number theory. And this is as fundamental in computer science as storing information and securing it and transmitting it over a channel. So there are many groups with different interests who try to implement some of these things in practice. And so my guess is that whatever fundamental progress we make in computational algebra and algebraic complexity, sooner or definitely later, they will seep into the practical applications.